is Jello Biafra. Which would you rather have? A pint of booze if you're a recovering alcoholic, or a pint of cacophony no matter what or who you are?
Speak into the mic, bitch.
Say that into the microphone.
Keep on rocking in the free world, and I mean rock, not pop punk. Not indie poo. Not middle of the road, Miley Cyrus-y dreck.
You're a freak with a microphone.
Good evening, ladies and shitheads. Welcome to another episode of A Pint of Cacophony. My name is Dan Pacinillo. This is SkidRowStudios.com, and you can call us here at 800-893-9562. 800-893-9562. If you have the balls, I don't know. Whatever.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah! Anyways, we got Vimdicta in studio today. We're going to play a bunch of shit off of their last release. It's going to be a bunch of fun. But first off, Jello Biafra played last night at the Roxy.
Fuck yeah, he did.
Yeah, fuck yeah, he did. That's the man who voiced our intro.
It is.
So we're going to go into a Jello block. No Dead Kennedys, even though they're true to my heart. We're going to play some Jello Biafra with No Means No, with the Melvins and Guantanamo School of Medicine. And let's get to it, and we're going to come back with... we sent Alex out onto the streets. To get deep down and personal with some of these Jello fans out of the show, in the pit, outside of line. We're gonna go through what he got.
Yeah.
Let's play some tunes first.
But why do they put a guarantee on the box then?
Because they know all they sold you was a guaranteed piece of shit. That's all it is, isn't it? Hey, if you want me to take a dump in a box and mark it guaranteed, I will. I got spare time.
Crowded, the lines are long. Every day I wonder, has someone got a bomb? I feel it on the bus, it could blow up. Tension in my teeth, that stabbing in my gut. I know that look in your eye, I've never seen you before. What's in the backpack? Oh God, not again! I don't wanna live in a world like this. You don't wanna live in a world like this. We don't wanna live in a world like this. No one should have to live in a world like this. Israel is killing itself. Palestine is killing itself.
the break, we're going to interview Eric Weihenmayer, who climbed the highest mountain in the world, Mount Everest. But he's gay. He's blind. So we'll hear about that coming
up. Okay. As we head to the break, a look at the 6 o'clock.
Right, motherfucker.
Somebody in the street, well, that's my falling knee. It's raining faces.
Viva Jello Biafra. He did our intro. I will always love that man. Dead Kennedys, post-Dead Kennedys. He played last night at the Roxy, didn't he, Alex?
Yes, he did.
And you were there, weren't you,
I was
Alex?
There.
How was that, Alex?
It was mind-blowing. That was the first time I've ever seen Jello live. Yeah. Yeah, it was fucking great.
Wasn't it?
Yes.
All right, man. Well, okay, that was all post-Dead Kennedys. So we had Jello Biafra from the Guantanamo School of Medicine doing Mid-East Peace Process, then Jello Biafra from the Melvins doing Those Damn Punk Kids, and then Jello Biafra with No Means No doing Falling Space Junk, Hold the Anchovies. That's what it's called.
Yes.
By the way, you're listening to A Pint of Cacophony. My name's Dan Patronillo. You can call us at 800-893-9562. Pretty soon, we're going to bring the Vim Dicta in here. But for now, I threw you on the spot in the show. I mean, at the show last night at the Roxy. I was like, I want audio.
Yes.
I don't care what the fuck you have to do or who you have to ask. I just want audio.
Yeah.
And you brought me audio, didn't you?
I got 7 clips for you.
Matt sitting here. He's my buddy from K-Rock. How you doing? He's got 7 clips from the Jello show.
How many hands did that take?
That took 2 hands. 2 hands.
Okay.
Let's hear him. Play the first one.
All right, so...
Walk me through these. What were you doing? How did it go down?
All right, so I got there. You know, I walked in. I got patted like 3 times. You know, I got my crotch grabbed at, but that's fine. And I started, you know...
You got in there with the recorder?
No, it was my phone.
Oh, okay.
So I just went in with my phone, and I started, you know, scoping around, and I found this couple. And so I went up to them... And asked him for an interview, and this is what happened.
You can do it, man. Here we go. Hey, guys. How you doing? I work for a radio station here in downtown LA called Skid Row Studios.
Oh,
I
what just a wanted sweetheart. To get some listen to
feedback
you.
From the fans, see what's up. You guys up for it?
I don't really feel like talking right now.
Oh, that's cool, man. You don't have to. You just say no.
All right, man.
All right, cool. Thank you. There's one rejection.
Good interview, though.
One rejection.
So you got rejected.
Yeah, I got rejected the very first person I went up to talk to.
You gotta be more assertive about your job, Alex.
I guess so, but...
What do you got next? You got another one? Did you actually get something out of somebody?
Yeah, so there was a guy. I'm wearing my Mexico jersey in honor of this guy, Sombrero Man.
Sombrero Man.
Some big sombrero, Mexican jersey, and a Mexican flag tied around his neck as a flag. And I got to talk to him, and this is what happened.
All right, man, we're gonna go talk to this guy that's wearing a Mexican shirt and a Mexican hat to the Jello show. I don't know. Let's just see what he has to say. Let me go see. Well, Greg, can I ask you guys some questions?
Nothing incriminating, honestly.
No. Like
I wasn't expecting
okay.
that voice.
So my first question is, I like the outfit.
Yeah.
He's wearing a Mexican shirt. It looks like a soccer jersey.
Todo Mexico.
Todo Mexico.
1994.
I think I have the same one.
Yeah.
And I do.
Yeah, you're wearing it right now. It's fucking weird.
Because I'm Sombrero Man.
Sombrero Man at the Jello Biafra show.
Sombrero Man, yeah. How did I know I would be Sombrero Man? I just saw Sombrero and nobody else wears Sombrero, so I became Sombrero Man.
Sombrero Man.
So nobody
you
wears.
You ran into this fucking guy at the Jello Biafra show?
And I kept talking to him.
Okay, so we're getting in-depth with Sombrero Man here. So have you got to a lot of shows, like, in the LA area? Where can we find you?
The Vandals, TSOL, at the now-defunct Weber's. They don't exist, you know. Weber's doesn't exist, but they're there. NoFX.
NoFX.
Coming soon to Punk Rock Bowling.
Oh, yeah.
All 3 days.
Don't call me white.
Yeah, don't call me white.
Don't call me white.
Don't call me paisa.
Don't call me paisa.
Don't call me brown, dude.
Yeah, don't call me brown, yeah.
Oh, man. Well, what's the next show after this one you're going to be doing? Maybe we could find you somewhere.
Punk Rock Bowling.
Punk Rock Bowling?
That so motherfucker would be a punk rock bowling.
Man's gonna be at Punk Rock Bowling. Who are you most excited to see?
Over there, it's NoFX. Oh, you know what? Manic Hispanic at the club show.
Manic Hispanic at the club show. So find Sombrero Man there.
Yeah, you'll find me there.
I hope people actually find them and tag us on it. Just
they should,
see,
yeah. If you see Sombrero Man, fucking take a picture and tag our show.
You cannot miss them with that Mexican flag. And then I talked to this older couple that was there.
Okay.
Jennifer, really sweet, and this is what happened.
Hi, so I see that you're wearing a Death Him shirt.
Yeah.
Big fan?
Yeah.
How long have you been following them?
Not very long.
No? Oh, so you're a newer fan.
I'm a newer fan, yeah.
So are you here for Jello or are you here for anybody else?
Death Him.
Okay, Death Him. Have you ever been to a Jello show?
No.
Oh, you're in for it.
Yeah.
No.
Are you nervous?
No.
No? Maybe.
I'm Jennifer and I'm listening to A Pint of Cacophony.
Oh, what a sweetheart.
Yeah, she could have been more sweet.
How old?
Yeah, how
pretty
old?
Pretty old. Yeah, she was an older couple with her husband, I'm assuming. Very nice. And then I talked to one more guy before Jello started and it ended kind of abruptly.
All right, just a couple questions. Cool, man. What's your name?
Bob.
Bob, how you doing? I like that shirt, dude. Fucking circle jerks. You here? Are you ready for Jello?
Yeah, I'm ready for Jello.
Yeah, what are you expecting to hear?
songs, like about four or five old Dead Kennedy songs.
Okay, which ones?
Kill the Poor. Soup is good food, I'd like to hear, but I don't think they'll do that one.
Do you think they'll play anything off Democracy? That's my favorite album.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I
fucking hope so. Awesome, dude. And what do you think of the other bands, like Butcherettes and Death Hand Number 9? The first
he had
bands?
No idea.
Yeah,
who they were.
Yeah, they were good. Yeah,
I heard
he
you talking
wasn't
about
even
off.
There.
He wasn't there.
Yeah, man. I think he's starting.
Yeah.
Awesome, dude. Thank you so much, man.
All right.
Enjoy the show.
Alex is still trying to do an interview.
Oh man, I just got. Here comes Shuttle Bianca.
I was just really excited.
You sound like it. It's adorable. You're like, oh my god, jealous.
Do you want to hear me in the pit?
Yeah, I do. You have that.
Here it
Let's
is.
Hear it.
Oh, shit!
Alex reporting from in the pit at Jello Biafra.
Right in front of me! Oh! Yeah! Jump
I start singing.
Listen, Alex, he's having so much fun.
I don't know if you can hear this!
Apparently you can.
Yeah, absolutely.
Who would have thought, right, out of a little recorder like that?
That's awesome.
And then this is the last clip. This is my favorite clip, just because Jello Biafra was starting to, you know, get into this groove.
He gets in your face. He gets on top of you.
And that's what happened.
Yeah.
And during California, Uber Alice.
There's Alex again screaming.
He was right in front of me, by the way.
I'm sure he was. So needless to say, we're sending you to every show.
Hold on.
This guy just landed right on top of me. Jello Biafra right on top of me, Dan. That was insane.
Y'all talking to me like I was fucking there.
Right, like you were talking to me.
Oh, Dan.
I didn't get very much, but that's what I got.
Wait till Dan hears this.
Good job, man.
Thank
we're
you.
Sending you to good. Everything.
I want
Are you
to.
Going off on Tuesday?
No, but I'm going to Desert Days. I'm going to go see Deep Valley.
Nice. Record all
redhead.
That shit, man. That's going to be fun. All right.
Yeah,
sweet.
That should be good.
Let's get back to some tunes, and then we'll get Vimdicta in here. Yeah?
Yes.
Yeah, let's play some Fiddler, Bitchwax, and then we're bringing on the new Vimdicta with Von Tango. Hit that shit, Alex.
The gods have seen fit to give me another shot with the soulmate. She's in New York feathering the nest, and I got to be ready for her. Mentally, physically, sexually.
Maybe it's time to stop banging the entire college campus.
Right you are, motherfucker. Right as rain.
Thank you. today's winner, today's kid reporter is Deirdre Shores. It's you, Deirdre, it's you.
It's you, Deirdre.
It's you. Huh?
You're the winner. You're today's kid show kid reporter winner.
Man, I got a double super buzz. Here I was a-huffing airplane glue in a sandwich bag. You know, just all I could have breathed it on into my lungs and getting high. And then I'd take me a hit of that gas right after I'd hit. Man, you talking about a warped mind, I got one. And lighter fluid, you know, I'd sniff hit by the cans. I mean, I was Superman.
House up, high
Welcome back to Pint of Cacophony. My name is Dan Patronillo. This is SkidRowStudios.com, and I'm sitting here with the Vim Dicta. Hi, guys.
Hello.
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 Tell me how you doing. How you doing?
We're doing good. Slightly buzzed, but good.
Yeah. Matt, Corey, and Chris here. How you guys all hanging? Cool.
Some buzz, but hanging good. Loose. And
getting loose.
I almost made a penis joke, but I'm going to leave that alone.
Too early in the show. We can do it.
We just
time
started.
For penis jokes galore.
Cheyenne, our intern, She brought back, a childhood game. I don't know. We brought it up in the green room, and Chris was like, what the fuck? I haven't played that since I was 12.
Yeah.
But yeah. What is this, Cheyenne? What are we doing?
Well, the game is called Two Truths and One Lie. So basically, everyone gets to tell us two true things about themselves and throw us off with a lie. And we get the chance to figure out what the hell they lie to us about.
So we got Matt here, Cheyenne, Chris, Corey, Anna, Alex, or Bordop.
Yes.
I got all your fucking paperwork, so let's just go through this. If you guys get it wrong, you drink. That's it.
Sounds great.
Sounds easy?
Right,
all
right at home.
All right, this is Matt's, so you don't get an answer. All right, so is this fact or lie? I was David St. Hubbins in a Spinal Tap tribute group.
Fuck yeah, I hope it's true.
Fucking fact.
You're supposed to answer these?
You're supposed to guess if it's a fact or not.
Well,
you already knew that about him, didn't
know.
You?
I know.
You fucked up.
Yeah, you gave away the answer, bro.
I'm sorry.
I never played
cool,
this
man.
Game as
Lock
a child.
That's okay.
Yeah,
you
true.
Can still drink.
Okay, I drink for you.
All right, is this fact or lie for Matthew? I hate America.
Lie.
Lie.
Oh, you like kind-spirited towards our country?
He's wearing a Che Guevara shirt.
I have a heart. I love Che, but America could use a little bit of him right now.
Yeah.
We need a furious leader that comes down from the hills and just frees us all.
Well, if you know that's lie, then we already know this is fact. I am a certified laboratory technician. Did not know that about you. It says Breaking Bad status. Shit, bitch.
Shit, bitch.
That's what shit, dot, 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 bitch.
Yeah.
Interesting. Now we know a little bit more about Matt. Cheyenne, your turn. All right, facts or lie? I'm bipolar. What do you guys think?
Oh, that's true.
Yeah, I guess it is.
Oh, was I right? Oh,
yeah,
I was
you were
kidding.
Right. You were trying to be mean.
I was.
I had an imaginary friend named Francesca when I was 5.
Ooh. Vim Dicta?
True.
I'm gonna go with true on that
true.
One.
It's too revealing.
I secretly love to do shrooms on my free time. That's obviously the bullshit.
Oh.
Too easy, Cheyenne. Chris.
Well, then there you go. His options are too appealing, actually.
Yeah.
All right, is this fact or lie, Chris, from the Vim Dicta?
Uh-oh.
I once had sex 27 times in a week. 27 times in a week.
Oh,
what is that, about
them.
3 or 4 a day? Right?
Give or
at
take.
At least.
I think I did.
24?
27.
7 days in a week, at least.
Lie.
That's a lie? You guys think lies?
I can
no way.
Consider it to be true. Chris, it's true, isn't it?
It's under fact.
Oh!
It is true.
That's interesting, man. It's stamina.
High five.
No,
fair
that's stamina. I was in bad shape at the end of that week, though.
That's good stamina.
Chafing.
My God.
Wow.
I was in pain.
Talk about rawness,
K-Y.
Man.
K-Y.
Yeah.
All right, fact or lie for Chris. I love Kesha and Justin Bieber.
That's a lie.
Dude, you had to put Bieber in there. If you would have just left it at Kesha, maybe like people would have...
It would have been a little bit more believable.
You
maybe
ruined
the-
it.
Trashy.
You ruined it.
Has anybody seen her naked online yet?
No, I haven't.
Oh my God.
She doesn't have a sex scandal yet?
She does. She has some dude's jizz on her, literally.
Really?
Seriously, no, I'm not lying.
Has she?
Everybody go online.
We'll look it up.
Kesha.
I mean, are the days of the celebrity sex tape over?
It's
super interesting.
Is that pretty much done now?
No, it's not done now. It's at the point these days where that's how people get famous.
That's what I thought. I thought that was
so kind
of like a thing.
It's not done now. It's not like a thing that happens to like reinvent your fucking career. It's just a thing to start one.
Unless you're
Nick Cannon. Which is sad. You know what's bullshit is they even produce them and then they leak them. With like decent lighting and everything.
I mean, didn't it start with Paris? No, it started with Pamela, didn't it? Pamela Anderson. Anybody
what,
know?
The underground Amy? Revealing sex tape that just comes up out of the blue?
Somebody just left it out. Did you hear about the Marilyn Monroe one that's going around?
Is it
what?
Going around? I've
no, it's
seen
not. It's not going around. It's like there's a lot of money involved keeping this thing in wraps. But basically, it's a threesome between her and the Kennedy brothers.
No.
What?
That's not true. This is a real thing. And like this guy just spent like a grip of money. He's a friend of who? John Montana, right?
Joe Montana.
Was her husband, right?
Her ex. Yeah, her husband.
Okay, it was in his closet. When he died, he left it to his best friend, and he's the one who's holding it. He refuses to let it go.
They must have been great friends.
He's dropping like all this cash to keep it under wraps, but that's supposedly it's the Kennedy brothers.
Off topic.
Wow. Well, everybody,
are we listening to the Mask soundtrack?
Yeah, this is the Cuban beat of the Mask.
Oh my God!
If that's not the American dream,
we have the best music beds here on a Pint of Cacophony. We don't fuck around.
Holy cow, man! I love this movie.
it's the shit, isn't it?
It's kind of the shit.
Oh, we're playing a game here. Fact or lie with Corey. Here we go. I was really good at basketball.
True.
Fact.
Awesome. We should fucking play in the parking lot.
Let's go.
Let's do it.
Ball you down.
She's gonna like she plays her dirty. Versus everybody, and she's just gonna fucking kick our asses.
She's gonna hit all the fadeaways.
White person three pointer. You know the Dirk, the Larry Bird.
All right, fact or lie? I met Bon Jovi. Ball. She said she met Bon Jovi. Fact or lie? She
fucking
met Bon Jovi.
Lie.
Was he living on a prayer?
Total.
Okay, fine. It's a lie. But if you did meet him, what would you do? Would you be friendly?
I would make out with him.
You're a Bon Jovi fan?
No.
Then why would you make out with him?
Because I'm kidding.
Oh.
I would probably punch him.
Would you punch him? You wouldn't be like, oh, hey, dude, and leave him alone? Like.
Yeah, because I would probably be the only girl that would ever punch him. Because every woman is obsessed with him, I feel like.
I think every woman, like, over 40 is obsessed with Bon Jovi.
I mean.
Like the Ally McBeal demographic. Wasn't he on that show? He was also in U571 with Matthew McConaughey. I've seen way too many movies.
U571.
I haven't seen that.
Yeah.
Is that like a plane?
Oh wait,
movie?
No, it's about submarine.
About the U-boat or?
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, man.
Yeah,
I love
fucking
that movie.
Bon Jovi's in that movie.
Yeah, all short hair and like what was it? Like a buzz cut look.
Dude, Chris, me and you've been like totally connecting on movies all fucking day. This is crazy,
dude.
What was the one we were on in there? I don't remember the words.
Oh,
basketball.
No, it wasn't.
No. What were we talking about? I can't remember now.
It's not important. Let's finish this.
Yeah.
We'll get to it.
Mask.
Was it? Well, the Mask was recently. Alex, we got Fact or Lie.
It was Sex and the City, right?
No, I think it was Sex and City, season 7, right?
Episodes first or the movie?
Where Sarah actually falls in love.
You guys know it.
Is there somebody named Sarah on that show? Horseface, Sarah Jessica Parker.
Yeah, for sure. I think her name is Sarah.
Alex the Board Up. We got Fact or Lies here with Alex the Board Up. I love the Rocky Horror Picture Show.
Ooh.
Fact or Lie.
Are they going
to Everybody says true. True?
Yes, it's true.
On Santa Monica at the New Art?
All right, here we go. Okay. Fact or Lie. I hate the fact that Dan hates the Beatles.
Are they going to answer or do I answer?
And Dan, as in you?
Yeah, me. Like, he hates the fact that I hate the Beatles.
Oh, that's true.
That's true.
You just kind of said it.
No, people, that's what he said. I hate the fact that Dan hates the Beatles. You think it's true?
It's true.
You think I hate the Beatles?
Oh.
He can think they're overrated.
I don't know.
But
I think he just gave
them.
It away. I think that's a truth.
That's true.
I was upset with Alex for writing this one down because I figured it would start some shit.
It's too revealing. It's way too revealing.
Wow.
Way too revealing.
Me and him at a Super Bowl party yelled at each other for like 40 minutes over this.
Wow.
Why do you hate them?
Yeah.
We'll get to that. We'll get to that in a second.
Okay.
But his last one, fact or lie, Dan gave me a massage once and I felt it move.
Fact. Fucking fact.
Fact.
They're all facts.
It's a fact. They were all facts. That's the thing.
They're all facts.
Let's play some Tame Impala and then Vim Dicta.
Love those guys.
Point blank off of Von Tango, yeah?
Yep.
Yes. Yeah. Von Tango.
We're going to have you guys in here right when we get back. And then let's talk about your music.
We'll talk. We'll
skitch.
Get personal? I'll get personal.
Let's get personal.
I'll go toe to toe and personal tip with you.
You go chest to chest?
Chest to chest.
Chest bump?
Hair to hair.
Eyelash to eyelash.
Heat to heat. It's on.
You can play the song at any moment now.
What happened, man? What's your problem?
Can you believe it? I got fired. I've had this job for years, and out of nowhere, they tell me to pack up and leave. I don't get it. I don't deserve this, and I need this income.
Really? That doesn't sound right, man. You need to do something about this. You should get someone to help you fight this.
Imagine losing your job for something out of your control or being harassed at work. In this economy, we depend so heavily on our sources of income. Getting it taken away from us for wrongful reasons is devastating. If you've been wrongfully terminated from your job, call attorney Alexander Fuquay at Fuquay Law Center. He'll fight for you. Contact by phone at 626-385-8840 or visit his website at www.fuquaylawcenter.com. Fuquay Law Center serves anywhere in California, including Los Angeles, San Diego, and Orange County.
We'll be right back. We accept her, we accept her.
Google gobble, Google gobble.
One of us, one of us.
Google gobble. They're going to make you one of them. My peacock.
Google God.
Welcome back.
Yo.
We're sitting here with Matt. What's up, dude?
What's up?
You got Corey. How you doing?
Yo, yo.
Yo, yo. Chris, what's up?
Hey.
My new movie friend.
We are like the new Siskel and Ebert, man.
Do you want to come over and we'll just watch movies?
Please. Wait, what?
You just come over. I'll make you dinner and we'll watch movies.
Like a date night?
No, not like a date night. We're just going to watch movies with some candles or something.
I want to cook you some pasta.
Well, you know what? Yeah, I mean, you put enough PBR in me, maybe I'll give you a kiss on the cheek and hold your hand.
Dude, we'll watch Point Break and, like, Con Air and shit.
Point Break? Yeah, Okay,
now we're talking.
Done. I won't even mind, like, accidentally bumping into your hand in the bowl of popcorn, man.
Hey, guys, let's do it.
I don't think that's going to be my hand in the bowl of popcorn.
Uh-oh.
What's
up? Is that going to be sitting in your lap?
Could this be your song?
This is our song. Did you? What is this?
How did you know?
So sentimental.
How did you know?
Up in
hell. My God. Okay.
So, well, I got the Vindicta here.
Just your average band.
Let's get one by one. Let's get one by one, just real quick. If you weren't musicians, what would you be doing for a living? If you guys didn't fucking play music, Matt, you first. What would you be doing?
I really wanted to be a cop. I know, right?
Why?
I don't know why.
Fucking false.
I don't know. No, that's cool. I guess I wanted power in things, and in music, I have power over actual voltage and watts of, like, power and electricity, you know?
Interesting.
And, like, get to freak people out that way. If I was a cop, I would just look at them in my very Cartman-esque way and just make my hair down and all that, you know?
Corey, what about you?
Probably a stripper or something.
You'd be a stripper?
Yeah.
You're like, yeah, straight up stripper.
That's my natural, like...
Is that why you're naked in your music video?
No, not really.
No, that's not why.
Probably, like, something in the film industry.
Yeah?
Because I wanted to, like, act and
like
stuff.
An extra?
No, I've done that.
You've done the extra?
That's not enough spotlight
You want to be a leading lady.
Yeah.
Porn.
Like a Hitchcock girl or a James Bond girl.
Totally.
Yes.
You guys should write the new fucking James Bond song.
I think
you guys would kill
that.
It. Wouldn't they kill it, Alex?
Oh my God.
Could you picture the Vindicta?
Maybe we already have.
Oh shit.
Oh my God.
Mind foreshadowing.
Blow. Yes.
Chris, what about you? What's your profession aside from music?
Oh man. Done a lot of things.
That's easy. Sucking some guy's dick.
Oh my God. So I'm fucking the student in the ass, right? No, I'm kidding.
He was fucking me in the ass.
You're welcome.
That's how it
works. Hey,
you know
what?
You know what? You close your eyes, it all feels the same. Anyway,
as long as you don't make eye contact, it's
no
fine.
Eye contact. That's right.
As long as the balls don't touch, little duct tape, you're cool.
Man, this sounds like it should be my profession.
For those of you just tuning in, this is a radio show.
This is a radio show.
And my nieces are listening.
Oh, no.
No.
Corey, why don't you tell me about the coolest things you guys got going on these days?
So I think the coolest thing is this music media company out of Mexico and Latin America. They're the biggest one. They're called Life Box Set. They somehow heard about the band, and they really dig us, and they've posted a couple articles on us. And about us. And
in Spanish.
It's all in Spanish, so we're like, yeah! Like,
Google
like,
Translate for the win.
So like, you guys got, like, reviews and stuff, but en español.
Yeah.
Reviews like, we cannot read.
I feel good when I can read, like, a fourth of it.
Have you gone through and trying to translate it for yourself?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And how are they?
The title of one of them is A Tornado Called the Vindicta.
Yeah, they're
which
very
is
flattering.
Super epic. I love that one.
They're like, the Vindicta is going to save rock.
And fuck like, yeah.
El primo candidato de Savior de Rock and Roll, which is el prime candidate to save.
Viva
rock.
Vindicta.
It's
you guys should make stickers.
Heavy.
Viva Vindicta.
It's a great
Vindicta
idea.
And like hand them out down there.
Man, that's actually a really good idea.
Great.
With like the upside down exclamation mark and then the right side up one on the other side.
That's a party. Yeah. I always think party when I see that.
Shirts and everything. Ass tattoos. The whole shebang.
Yeah, so...
Pinata.
I don't know, they've been posting about us, and like we got a bunch of new fans out of it from, you know, that area.
From that country.
And they're like posting on our YouTube videos in Spanish and stuff with like exclamation points.
And he was like, I don't know what the fuck this is, but this is so cool.
But they look so happy posting it.
Yeah.
The posts look happy.
That's awesome. Good for you guys.
A couple of them from that company were at South By, and they came to one of our shows and like.
No way, that's awesome.
Yeah, they were really like you know, complimentative, and we did like a little video interview with them, mm-hmm. and they're just like, like bowing down
is,
to us.
It's is the video crazy. On the internet somewhere?
It's not up yet for some reason, but there's a little.
When it does, will you send it to me? We'll put it on our page because I'd like to see that. I'm sure a lot of our audience would love to as well.
Yeah, I'll send you the links to like the other articles too. There's like two articles about us.
Right on.
Posted, yeah.
I also just noticed Google the Vindicta and Life box set. I always like to cut the chase and use Google. Be like, yeah, that's what two things am I thinking about?
Boom, and it solves a problem like, for you. So, Vindicta Live box set, you'll find them. I also saw that you guys were in the top three for the LA Weekly poll. Why don't you tell me about that? Tell me, what was the poll?
Corey, go.
For the LA Weekly.
Best live band in LA.
Best fucking live band in Los Angeles.
We're going to do it.
You guys are in the top three. Vindicta.
It was a fans vote type thing.
Right. Mm-hmm. It was a poll.
And there was a couple rounds of it. So yeah,
which were hell, by the way.
So how'd that all go down? Like,
well, you know,
very controversial.
Controversial? How so?
There were two worlds of it. Like, because you know, we have a little studio lockout at the Bedrock Studios over in Echo Park.
Right on.
We would actually run into members of bands we were competing against,
and you like give each other the eyes, like motherfucker.
Kind of,
you guys going down next round?
I will eat your babies, bitch.
It's exactly right.
That's what Chris was doing. He's getting in their faces, and you guys were like holding them back.
Oh my god.
We're just here to practice.
Like, we're just trying to just do a be thing, peaceful, man.
No, it was really weird because
people take that personal. Huh?
Well, I mean, when it's people's choice, and I think it was, what was it like the first round, we ran away with it.
Yeah,
for
we
a
did.
While.
Really?
And of course, we got and it was cool, but it was like, you know, we were so like passive about it. Not like that we didn't care.
No, just humble.
But it was like, wow, this is cool. And then we have like the lion's share of messages coming in going, oh, you guys are cheating and you guys are buying votes.
No way.
You
got like accused?
Yeah.
So it was like, gonna hate.
You guys are like Neil Armstrong and the Tour de France.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Well, actually, all that kind of was true at the end. But that's not for us.
I didn't think it would
hate
be.
Hate is going to hate. Love is going to love.
But the funny thing is the people that were accusing us were actually cheating.
Oh, well, yeah.
Yeah, they were the ones buying votes.
They were like, we're doing this fucked up thing to try and get votes. They seem to be doing it better if they are. So they must be doing what we're doing better.
Yeah.
Fucking cheaters.
It's like they did it to scare us or something.
Right.
Make us feel guilty, but at the same time.
Isn't it funny how like sometimes the music scene ends up just a little bit like high school?
It's like that. And so we're like,
sure.
No, I mean like it's weird. Like sometimes you walk into a club and you think you're just playing a show and then like there's this just like weird aura going on and you're like,
isn't it full of people that are just trying to avoid responsibility? That's like a high school student, isn't it?
I guess you're right, man. We're big babies.
We're just playing a child's game, man. It's like professional athletes until we make music.
But how can you even compete? I mean, we're trying to do something different.
No, I know what you
everyone.
Mean.
Yeah. It's just stupid, all of it.
But that being said, I hope they think I still look cool.
With that hair, Matt, you can never look
uncool. I'm going to fucking cut it, I swear to God. Dude, swear to God.
You should just fucking shave the whole... Can
Cuba. Like live poll? Yes.
No,
I'm
like
down.
In May. Do you want to come in here and can I shave your head on the air?
Yes, you can.
Seriously? Can
yes,
we shake
can.
On this right
you
now?
You can shake on
in
it.
In May.
Seriously?
You can shake on it.
Give me your fucking. Yes.
Oh just my God.
I'm shaving Matt's head on the air.
Did that just happen?
Gonna cut my hair now.
I don't believe he'll do it.
I'm not going to do it.
You're gonna remember.
There's no way he's gonna do this.
Hold on a second. You're gonna remember this tomorrow morning.
I'm gonna remember. Are you kidding? This is two paths Lutherans in. Do you know me?
No, I don't. This is like the first time we've actually hung out.
Give me about 10 PBRs, then I won't know what I'm talking about. But now, I do it. Because I want to start working out, you know, and I think it'll be good with the bald head, you know, by summertime.
All right, I'll bring some clippers in, and we're going to shave your fucking
it's
head.
Be good.
Just clippers. No,
no,
don't
clippers.
Shave it. Just clip it.
No, we're gonna, a little scraggly.
No, this is what we're going to do. We're
like
going to go clippers
one.
Down. Pretty No, on a zero, just nice and close. And then I'm going to put the Nair on.
Okay. The Nair on? I look so Asian.
And I'll bring a warm, damp cloth, and we'll wipe it off your head. And like a baby's ass. I'll leave
like
your head
a baby's
feeling
ass.
Like a baby's ass.
Oh, my God, bro.
Oh, my God.
Gonna totally
so
take
Asian
the nitty of your head. Gonna
hair,
make it bald.
Matt's hair is, like, part of him. Like, that's what people recognize
that's what
him
think.
By.
You shouldn't have told him not to shake my hand.
No, it's in May. It's next month, though, right?
Like, if there's
Seriously.
A picture
that's
of only a shadow of you, people would recognize you.
That's fine. Is it after May 6th?
If you want.
I do it after May 6th. How about that?
Why? What's
oh, my God.
I got a show I might need my hair for, you know.
Because we're definitely not playing a show after May
6th. Yeah, for sure. No, we are, but they can deal with my hair being shaved and shit.
Speaking of shows, before we get back to some tunes, why don't you guys tell me about what's coming up? Yeah. What do you guys got going?
Corey, go.
Corey, go.
We are definitely playing the Echo on the 6th with Dead Sarah.
May 6th.
May 6th, the Echo.
Mm-hmm.
Cool.
And then we have a potential, it's like not confirmed yet, but the Roxy on the 19th of this month.
I'm
the
there.
Roxy. That's where he was with Jello Biafra and all those clips earlier.
And I'll be there getting the crowd.
And he'll show up. And he's going to record everything. We'll do the same thing with you guys.
Cool.
The day we shave your head.
Mm. With, we shaved my head on that
Aqua
day.
Aqua Dolls, that's badass.
And La Femme.
We played them on Rodney's show at K-Rock.
Cool. Isn't it with La Femme too?
La Femme.
And the
I don't know La Femme, though. But
I don't.
We can still talk about them. It's okay. Yeah. We can make assumptions.
We can mention them.
I think in their past lives, they were firefighters. What about you? What do you think?
Maybe.
Yeah, maybe.
Aquatic engineers.
Yeah. And then, yeah, we have another show on the 7th, but that's in San Francisco.
San Francisco, where, though?
Where are we playing?
Oh,
I forgot the name.
Oh, God, I can't believe we...
The Vindictive with
the smartphone.
That's all good. Why don't you guys just send it to me and we'll post it up on the page. You guys can catch up there. We'll find out what the Vindictive is playing.
About this right now.
People in San Francisco, look for us. I know you're up there. I'm talking to you directly right now.
Oh, my God, they love us there.
That's awesome. It makes a lot of sense. I really want to thank you guys for stopping by. It's been a ton of fun.
Yeah, I got one thing I want to mention.
Sure, mention.
Wait, is it Monday still? Is it still Monday?
Actually, no. What? Yeah, no, it's not. It's Tuesday morning.
Damn it.
Why?
Okay, we got to give a shout out to our manager, our awesome manager.
Dan Nash's birthday.
Dan Nash. Damn it's his birthday. It's his birthday still.
10 minutes ago.
No, In Hawaii, it's still his birthday.
For sure.
Dan Nash, happy fucking
best
birthday, man. We
happy
love
birthday,
you.
Dan.
Stories
I've been talking to him for a while, trying to get you guys in here, so... Happy birthday, man.
Bastion of Goodwill.
He's 60.
Barely.
Barely.
I'm sure he's wise.
He very wise.
He's
very
like
wise.
160-year-old.
Well, he's helping 60 you guys out and everything. He must be.
No, seriously, he's 60 going on 25. We love you, Dan.
Yeah, we love you, Dan.
And we love you, listeners.
I hope he likes this interview.
He's like, we can't use it. Scrap it.
This is bullshit.
Scrap it. All right, anyways, let's get back to some tunes, but thank you guys for coming. You're listening to A Pint of Cacophony. My name's Dan. Let's listen with some No Bunny.
This is Stan Mikita's Donuts. Excellent munch boss. This is the manager, Glenn. He's here 24 hours a day. I recommend the Sugar Pucks. They're excellent. Come on.
I'd never done a crazy thing in my life before that night. Why is it? If a man kills another man in battle, it's called heroic. Yet if he kills a man in the heat of passion, it's called murder.
Hello! What do you think you're doing? Only me and Garth get to talk to the camera. Come on.
I don't really have too much to say right now. What's that?
Hi, Mr. Withers. How's the amusement park going?
Just great, Wayne.
4 coffees and a half dozen crullers, please.
Thank you.
somebody would get a picture of you, and then it would be posted all around, and it'll happen in your office.
Yeah, possibly.
You don't think so?
Well, it depends, you know.
Dina, I've got some time and a camera. Why don't you stop by? No. Okay. We'll be right back.
This is a Pint of Cacophony. My name is Dan Patronillo. You're listening to us here at www.skidrowstudios.com. You can catch us every Monday. Every Monday. 11 p.m. Oh. Vim Dicta.
Vim Dicta. Yo.
Vim Dicta. How'd you guys...
That's us.
Did you guys have a good time here? We had Corey Mantis here.
It was fun.
We sustained and kept our buzz. We were able to communicate with other people in doing so.
We're high off conversation.
Ah.
It was like a mini vacation.
Podcast people.
They seem so pleased with their time here.
It looks like it.
Look at smiles.
I had a great time.
Look at the smiles.
We're so happy.
Well, we heard Nobunny doing Gone for Good, Fu Manchu with their new one, Anxiety Reducer. And that was Stallion by Vim Dicta.
Yours truly.
Yours truly.
LA's.
So where can we find your guys' stuff, just real quick? Like right off the bat, just Google.
Facebook.com/VimDicta, VimDicta.com.
Instagram,
VimDicta.bandcamp.com. Google plus the Vim Dicta is your friend, because we are the only band in the world
we're
named...
on everything that all the normal the person would be on Instagram, Facebook, Twitter.
Awesome.
I follow them on Instagram.
Very easy to find. We're on iTunes again.
Really?
I do.
We're on iTunes. I think we're on Bandcamp.
Bandcamp is a great one. We were just re-released on iTunes.
We were just re-released on iTunes. It's thevimdicta.com and, of course, the Facebook. And
Von Tango is that last release you guys did that we just played all these songs off of, right?
We played them live.
A few emails into the show. Just like come message us. We'll get you some saucy talk.
Well, seriously. Just to wrap this up, I'd like to thank you guys, like, seriously, for being here. And
I'm
super stoked to have you guys back in a month because we're shaving Matt's head.
Yeah, we are.
We're gonna put some newspaper
after
down.
The show. I'm down. We could do it that same night, actually.
It can only get worse.
Is it a Monday?
Is the 6th of Monday of May?
We'll figure it out.
We'll do it.
We'll update you guys and keep you guys posted on Matt coming in here and us buzzing his head and narrowing his entire body.
I don't think he has hair anywhere.
I have
some hair that need. Okay, I'm gonna stop with that.
Just one last thing I want to tell you guys. Just Fuquay Law Center is who you want to call if you're being arrested for a DUI. They will explore every factory case to get you the best possible outcome. Shh, guys, for a second. Let them use their expertise to fight your case through the legal system. Call Fuquay Law Center at 626-385-8840 for a free consultation or email them from their website at www.fuquaylawcenter.com. Guys, I have business cards for the three of
you.
You
blew my mind.
Because you might need it.
I love it.
You never know.
I want it.
You never know.
You never know.
You never know. All right. Throw Rag. Sean Wheeler sings in that band. He's also in Sean and Xander. And at the end of the month, supposedly, hopefully, we're going to have him in here with Mario Lawley from Fatso Jetson. You stoked?
Yeah, fuck yeah.
So let's close this with some Throw Rag. This call is called Space Hump. The song is called Space Hump Me. Okay, we'll see you guys next Monday.
Later.
Good night, motherfuckers.
Thank you.
Yeah. That's the spirit. Thank you. Thank you for your honesty. Now fuck off and die.